to announce the winners. I defer the floor to you. Please. Michelle Chen and Kyra Bloomfield.
That's when you really get to know somebody's what kind of business, what makes you fulfilled inside is your business. So,
third, rent a
rent a dress. Megan McGuire.
This is just some general overall comments from my 27 years of banking and commercial financing experience. I just want to let you know that it's really important to do your research. I think that many people go into business and they don't plan enough. You can never underplan for starting a business. So keep up the good work with the business plans that you do have. Many of you had better business plans than I've seen in my 27 years coming out of adult, so hats off to you for all the work that you did and whoever your mentors were that helped you guide you through the business plans. I wanted to let you know that there's, in my experience in business, there's three components to the business. One component is the sales, so that's the person that's the salesperson. The other component is the worker bee. So maybe you're a furniture maker like the Eco Furniture Company. So you have the person that can build the furniture, and that person may be and probably is the best salesperson because they can explain the furniture, the quality behind it and everything. Then you also have the business part. So that's the person that deals with the finance and keeping your books. Hugely important to bankers, hugely important to your own lifestyle and everything like that. There's not many people that can do all three of those components successfully. Most of the time you can master two of those components. The third one you won't be able to master, and whatever that third component is for you. So reach out to help. You know, you'll have to get advice from lawyers, possibly from accountants, from bankers, from your parents, from your customers. Don't be afraid to reach out for help. And another little point is that in the planning portion of your business, when I was being trained for commercial financing, my potential customers were put into two buckets for me. One of the buckets was what we classed as tourists. The other bucket was what we classed as lovers. The tourist is the person that wakes up one morning and decides they want to start a business, and they just go whole hog and they open up this business. The lover is the person that plans for a long time in advance that they want to start a business. They eat, breathe, and sleep that business, and they will do anything to make that business work. From a banker's perspective, from a business person's perspective, that's the kind of person that we want to work with and deal with. So I encourage you to all go out there and be lovers.
John?
Thank you very much. This is our fifth, and I think I'm a lover. It's been 28 years with my wife, and we're still eat, live, and breathe our business every day. And I guess I've been up since 4 this morning, going over emails and keeping things up to date. And the banks do love us there, so. This is our fifth year with Thunder Bay Ventures doing the Enter the Den, and every year I come, and every year I'm totally amazed. And the caliber of the youth today is exceptional. And you know, the old adage, you know, the entrepreneurial spirit is alive and well in Thunder Bay, and everybody here can prove that. So congratulations to everybody. And as you're all sitting here, as you're only people here in the confines of this gymnasium, there are many times when it's slow and quiet, but it's reflective, and you can learn a lot, and you know, stick with it. It is hard work, but the reward at the end of the road is truly amazing. So we have the five winners, and you all are winners, but unfortunately they have to go from 5 to 1, so I was able to see 3 of the presentations, and I was able to meet Scott just at the end here. So Scott, you're number 5, and with Native Beadworks, and truly an amazing gentleman you are, and I'm sure with mentoring, there's a lot of people sitting at that table there would certainly be glad to help you out. I'm feeling a little emotional, but it's good to see, and congratulations. So if you want to come up. Come on up, Scott. And the fifth prize is a $200, I believe is a $100 gift certificate from Gear Up for Outdoors, and congratulations, Scott. The fourth place is a dual. I was not able to see this presentation. Was Michelle Chen and Kyra Bloomfield with Washful Deliver Laundry. And we have a $200 gift certificate from Gear Up for Outdoors, so you two will have to split that. Okay, we're into the top 3. And the third place is Megan McGuire from Rent Address. Come on up, Megan. And what is the third place?
There you go. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
Yeah, probably just down there.
Is there there's a certificate for the third, second, and first place that we'll give at the end. Is that correct, Barb?
Yes.
Okay. I can't remember the denominations of the prizing there, so I apologize. The second place winner is Caitlin Kotnin from Eco Custom Furniture. Great presentation. And the first prize winner is Alyssa Field from Pet Parking. I wish I'd seen this. This sounds like a great idea. Fabulous. So that concludes the presentation. Again, on behalf of the board of Thunder Bay Ventures, Chris is on our board here, and the others, we certainly enjoy this this yearly event, and hopefully next year we'll see some of you back again. Philip, one of our judges, he was in this, I think, for 2 years, and it's amazing to see the youth and of actually maybe using some of his business skills and in my business to do some apps. So, and we wish you the best of luck in your continuing education there, Philip. Thank you again.